All right, so this is Tuesday's handout, graphing systems, 8 problems is how it's titled. So I wanted to do at least one example of from each side. So on the front side, you have four systems problems, and they're already in slope intercept form. So what that means to you is the equations are ready to graph the way they're written. We can see that they are in y equals mx plus b form. So for number one, we're going to start at that y-intercept of positive 1. So it's here. And we know that there is an understood 1 in front of that negative x. That's negative 1. And we do need to make that a fraction. So it's negative 1 over 1. Remember, when you're dealing with negatives, that you can only use the negative symbol one time. So either the top number can be negative or your bottom number can be negative. You can do both of them on the same line, but you can only do this one or this one. You can never put double negatives up there, because if you have a negative divided by a negative, that is actually a positive answer. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start here, and I'm going to go down one, right one, and I'm going to do that as far as I can, and that's the line I get right there. And so if I do the opposite way, it should continue to line up with that existing line. So if I go up one and left one, up one, left one, up one, left one, indeed, it does continue that same exact line, and that's what we want to see. So that is the first equation. The second equation, we're going to start at positive 4. So that is here, and it says that we're going to go up 1, right 2. Well, I can go up 1 and right 2, and then I'm pretty much finished. So at that point, what I should do is the exact opposite. So if I take the original number, and I change both signs. Remember, you have to change both signs to do the opposite. And so now it's negative divided by negative, which means down 1, left 2. Now, this is the same thing as positive 1/2. These are equivalent fractions, because remember, negative divided by negative is actually a positive number. So these are equivalent to each other. And we know that this should line up going this direction. So if we start at our intercept and we go down 1 and left 2, down 1 and left 2, that does continue that exact same pattern, that same line. And so we do have a solution. This is a one solution equation, or a one solution systems problem. The solution is where the two functions, or the two equations, the two lines, where they intersect is my answer. And so this answer would be the coordinate right here where they cross. And this coordinate, the x value would be a negative 2, comma. And then we look to see how high up we are on the y value. The y value is a 3. So the answer would be negative 2, comma 3 for problem number 1. All right, I'm going to erase this, and we're going to do problem number 5 from the back. It's actually probably the hardest problem on this handout. So problem number 5. If you'll notice, problem number 5 is not in slope-intercept form. That means we're going to have to rearrange these equations to get them into slope-intercept form. So right now, all I'm doing is just rewriting this equation over here. Well, we notice this is the b, this is the y-intercept. It should be on the right-hand side of the equal. This positive 4 needs to be over here. And so negative 2y just comes down. There's my equal. X is okay, I'm going to write it as a 1x, so that's going to help me with my slope. And then this positive 4, when it comes over to this side of the equal, anytime you cross the equal, you must change the sign. So this positive 4 comes over as a negative 4. The last step is to divide everything by negative 2, because we want to cancel that out. So we get y equals 1 divided by negative 2 is negative 1/2x. Negative 4 divided by negative 2 is going to be positive 2. This one is now ready to graph. Start at my intercept at positive 2. The negative, remember, we said you can use it with the top number or you can use it with the bottom number. You just can't use it twice in the same problem, so I can't have negative 1 and negative 2. So if I start here, that guy says go down 1, right 2. Down 1, right 2, down 1, right 2. I can also do this direction, which would be up 1, left 2. Up 1, left 2, up 1, left 2. And you can see that that is the same continuous line. go ahead and erase this part so I have a little bit more room. So negative 1 minus x minus 1/3 y equals 0. Alright, so the negative 1, it needs to go all the way to the end over here. That's the intercept. And the negative x, it needs to go right here. So I'm left with negative 1/3 y equals. The next thing should be my x value. Well, it was a negative x, so when I bring it over to the right-hand side, it's going to become positive 1x. The negative 1 comes over as positive 1. The last thing I need to do is I need to divide everything by negative 1/3. That's the standard algorithm that we use to cancel it out. So we're just going to go ahead and divide everything by negative 1/3. So that cancels, and that leaves y equals 1 divided by negative 1/3 is going to be negative 3x. 1 divided by negative 1/3 is going to be negative 3 on the intercept. So I have negative 3. And then make that a fraction. And it says go down 3. Well, 1, 2, can't go down 3. Going to have to do the opposite. Remember, you can use the negative with either number. So if I move that negative to the bottom, now it says go up 3, left 1. 1, 2, 3, left 1. 1, 2, 3, left 1. Dots off just a little bit there. So I do have a solution. They actually intersect right here. Okay, so that is the answer right there. And so the solution to this problem is negative 2, 3. I believe that may have been the same answer as the front of the page. Negative 2, 3.